Stupid alien tricks. On day 3 of my brain napping, the aliens demonstrated some hilarious visual manipulations. They could put pixelated shadow animations in my peripheral vision of a running man. They could create subtle shadow illusions of children in the road. While it could make someone swerve who is unfamiliar with the technology, it was fascinating and amusing to see it done. I believe a horror movie was just released that demonstrates the ghost children who make people crash their cars. There are no ghosts, just shadow government testing of EEG heterodyning weapons. The visual cortex illusions seem to only work in dim lighting, which is intuitively what you would expect. Less sensory stimuli and information there is, the more easily external signals can influence the neurons. I interviewed psychic war test subjects that were fully convinced that they saw a wall open up into a war room with uniformed soldiers and other objects materialize. My visual cortex was never mapped that well, but you can see that fully conjured images as real as what is presented from your optic nerves can be induced in subjects. The technology seems to have gotten better since the 70s, when people just saw shadowy ghost-like figures in these hauntings. The ghost in the machine. Electronic warfare capabilities have become so refined that all electronic devices can be made to malfunction. The military-directed energy labs are perfecting ways to induce electromagnetic signals so precisely as to reprogram your computer or more easily influence your keyboard and mouse. If they can do it to a brain, they can do it with other electronics. Almost all targeted individuals report these kinds of tests of electronic control. I will save my amazing accounts for the movie of real footage in order for you to see and believe. These capabilities far exceed the older weapons of EMP and HERF that could stall your car or fry your data drives. The military gremlins are wreaking havoc in their electronic warfare exercises on the unsuspecting citizens. See the appendix for the Air Force Directed Energy Truly Futuristic Weapons description. Perhaps EMP and HERF weapons could be tested on the ionospheric heaters and their computing facilities to see if a minor disruption would cure thousands of people of pain and mental illness worldwide. Another perspective. Abstractly, think about the Earth's magnetic field as an ocean. If you move through it, you will create an electromagnetic wake which can be detected, since all charged particles have a resistance to motion when bathed in a magnetic pool, except if moving along the lines of the field. There is an effect called electron cyclotroic current driving. It is usually only studied under extreme conditions in high-energy physics laboratories. But it may be a possible mechanism of the current induced in the ionic channels of the Euro. Microwaves and a magnetic field is all you need. Lens effect from ionosphere signal bouncing. The Earth's ionosphere is spherical. This allows a phased array beam to be bounced off the ionosphere and focused on a point on the Earth. The total internal reflection only occurs at a certain angle from the source. Imagine you are in a swimming pool underwater looking up. You see people standing above on the edge of the pool, but when you look further away, you see the surface of the water acting like a mirror and reflecting the interior of the pool. This is exactly how the Earth's atmosphere acts with vacuum outside in space or at the ionospheric layers. So now imagine that the pool that you are in is somehow curved into a spheroid. When you look out of the pool, people will look smaller and the mirror portion will act like a telescope, amplifying small points inside the pool depending on your angle of view. The reflection amplification is due to the curvature, and the shrinking of the outside view is due to refraction effects. Do you get the picture yet? Satellites would have the reverse effect. The atmosphere would act like an amplifying lens at very high frequencies, making the Earth act like it is under a microscope, but this refraction effect is minimal at less than visible light spectrum. So these over-the-horizon radar systems, which are mostly used for viewing and tracking people, have their radar signals bounced off of the Earth's atmosphere in a doubt-like circle for the strongest energy areas due to the phenomena known as total internal reflection. The energy that does not hit the vacuum of space or different layers of the ionosphere at the angle of total internal reflection will have a much larger percent of its energy dissipated into space. Here's what it looks like. Now, more importantly, in order to find a point on Earth where people might find sanctuary from the United States virtual hell, we only need to calculate the angles of total internal reflection based on the index of refraction for various radar wavelengths to see the range in which they are active. The United States and NATO allies have 15 or more giant antenna fields covering most of the world, so intersection of all the active areas shows us that it is almost a total and complete global surveillance system. Interesting to note, though, is that the intersection of HAARP, the Brazilian, and Puerto Rico's radar fields and a couple other active fields all intersect over the United States and then cover the rest of the hemisphere. Even South Wales' ionospheric heat radar field can observe through the radar magnifying glass the United States citizens. However, due to the ozone holes over the North and South poles, the performance is different. This explains all the research interests from the DoD into eruptionic conditions and cold plasma. Every time there is a wake or anomaly in the smooth surface of the ionosphere due to a hurricane or some other event, the lens is disrupted and victims in that part of the world find relief from the killing and torture signals. After the last two major hurricanes in the United States, I received reports from victims that they escaped the torture during the hurricane. They of course came to the conclusion that the hurricane must have knocked out the power stations which ran the directed energy weapon. They were unaware of the ionosphere lens effect. This shows a defense weakness both in the continental ballistic missile surveillance system and the psychotronic torture system, which are one and the same. Eastern medicine. There is a technique practiced called healing hands, where practitioners move their hands without touching the patient all over the person's body who is experiencing discomfort, and somehow it makes them feel better. There is a psychological component to this, but since the ionospheric radar signals are so powerful, many people around the world feel the effects even if they aren't directly targeted for torture. The static electricity fields created between the healer and the patient are moved, and the body electrical resonances and electronic spin alignments are altered. The person feels better while the practitioner is doing it. Amazing how much human suffering these military surveillance systems are causing and have caused. Even the magnetic jewelry craze and negative ion generators that make people feel better can be linked to these radar signals and human surveillance techniques of bioelectric field modulation and reading. The cover story of ionospheric heating and observation of meteors is almost 99% bullshit in terms of the true purpose of these systems. More psychic phenomena explained. I, like most people, never understood the voodoo of quartz crystals that the New Age crowd was into. Some of the healing effects are of course due to the placebo effect and power of suggestion. But, so many people are affected by the scatter radar energy which has been around since 1960, that people have discovered things that make they feel better without knowing the exact underlying physics and biology. Negative ion generators are now standard in fans. Magnetic jewelry has become quite popular because of its lessening of pain effects. And quartz crystals work for some people. It turns out that quartz disrupts scatter radar fields due to the wavelengths at which they operate. So much pain and suffering throughout the world can be explained by the electromagnetic pollution of these stealthy scalar scatter radar systems tracking life forms. Silent assignations. Car crashes. The psychic soldier or CIA brain-damaged warriors can place shadows of children in the road so that you will swerve to avoid hitting them. Luckily, I was aware of the technology while they were performing their tests. People that were more susceptible to the visual cortex stimulation could easily see holographic-like images of children or people to avoid. If they were unaware of this military capability, they would swerve if they were good people. I found this to be absolutely amusing and astounding that they can create shadow-like figures, especially ones that haunt, running outside your peripheral vision. Useful if you want to get someone to follow the imaginary shadows, like lead a guard away from his post. Stupid alien pranks. In the continuous onslaught of psychological abuse, the DoD/CIA evil aliens tried to get me to fall for another degrading trick. Proudly, I can say I had caught on to their abusive pranks quickly. They would tell me in order to stop the pain and torture, all I had to do is ground my hands on the floor when I walked. They would project images of gorillas walking. The attempt at humiliation is self-evident. Humans and aliens, this planet isn't big enough for the both us. It obvious who we can do without. Directed energy silent assassinations. All radar technology uses a mathematical technique to calculate M-wave form effects called finite difference time domain in computational electrodynamics. This is important in calculating the properties of antenna design or near-field effects from waveforms. Using the same technique, it is possible to calculate a waveform's time domain effects on different human bodies, heads, organs, and brains. By modeling a human body and head, one could calculate the resonant pattern in the human body, that is the standing wave formations and where the high and low energy absorption nodes would be. So a directed energy weapon could be made more effective by precision targeting of energy to specific organs, for example. If you wanted to give a target diabetes, you could destroy some of the pancreas or alter the sugar metabolism in the cells. If you wanted to increase the chance of lung or brain cancer, the weapon merely needs to add energy to those locations and over time the probability will increase dramatically. Plausible denial and silent assassination techniques. Airplane crashes. Programmed assassins. Heart attack and stroke. Depression and suicide. Self-destructive behavior amplification. Poverty and medical treatment. Accidents, dark cloud. Walking in front of car. High voltage electricity. Gas stove. Drowning. Cause other people to misjudge. Oh doctor during an operation. Oh taxi driver. Like Princess Diana. Notes. Remote controlled heart attacks. Runaway adrenal process. Falling downstairs and breaking a hip or neck. Hypothesic to walk in front of car. While driving, running red lights, putting to sleep at wheel, forced steering into cars, emotional triggers to the point of road rage. Distraction of voices equivalent to cell phone and drinking. Inability to take necessary medications properly. Messing up body sensing ability can kill a diabetic who takes insulin. Forced depression state, subliminals of suicide. Seizure signal. Other situations where poor judgment could be life-threatening. Obviously, airplane pilots would be potentially deadly for many others. Disregard for the safety of other citizens who are not targeted for weapons testing. Children are being targeted and are far more easily influenced by voices. Told to play with parents' guns or sharp objects has been reported in several cases. Additionally, signals are amplified. So smoking and drinking habits would eventually lead to an early death. While I haven't heard of any events like this, directed energy weapons could be used to ignite gas stations, that is why cell phone use is not allowed near a pump. Certainly they could be used to take out an airplane by sparking the fuel tank, like what happened with Flight 800. Of course JFK Jr. supposedly got confused where the horizon was is a practiced psychic assassination. Creating mind-controlled assassins like the UA bomber. Remote-controlled lobotomies. So how does the United States dispose of citizens or ex-DOD employees? Delgado stated that people who think outside some defined norm should be surgically mutilated. I assume he thinks he is normal. If remote control-induced heart attack attempts fail and car crash attempts fail, the last resort is metasizatio. Also called zombification, schizotroic generators are now the preferred method since there is no blood and it is easily denied by the agencies and has been successfully kept in the science fiction belief realm of the general and purposefully ignorant populace. Euroamplification is easy if you have the Euro choice map of a particular mind. Amplifying every thought process like a thought echo would render a target dysfunctional, or disconnecting them from their mind amplification would turn them senile. Sounds like President Reagan. This amplification can lead to paranoia, an amplification of distrust and fear, or simply amplify erroneous thinking manifesting itself as delusional thinking. Hypothermia. Much of the psychic research and M-weapons research talks about hypothermia out of the blue. It always had me baffled as to what the link was between hypothermia or hypothermia and psychic research. It was never made clear in either the Russian or the United States literature. Then I found the connection in the least likely place. It turns out that one of the first brain signals and directed energy effects way back in the 60s was that the most promising kill application of the weapon, which was to cause hypothermia in a person. It is not an actual cooling down of the person by taking energy out of the system, but a vasoconstriction from the nervous system, like when one gets scared. There may be interference with the cell's metabolism too. This explains spooky haunted houses. People have reported that they felt a chill when a ghost was present. The apparitions or ghost images were simply early testing of EEG heterodyning with projected mental images or visual perception errors into people's minds. The vasoconstriction increases their fear and makes them feel cold so that they shiver. This is another reason why some people shake with extreme fear, such as observed in the famous cartoon series Scooby-Doo. I can see the crooks in the government now, saying Dagobit. We would have gotten away with it had it not been for you meddling saints, and your little dog too. Stupid alien tricks. If you don't kill your father in 1 hour, we will kill you by triggering an exploding microchip we implanted in your sinus cavity, ears, and tooth, my handlers said. An hour came and went. I begin to feel a popping sensation in my nasal cavity, then in my ears, then in my mouth. The microchips are releasing a poison into your system right now. The sensations really felt like Pop Rocks candy in my nose, ear, and mouth. Later the aliens told me that all four of them were sticking their fingers in their nose and flicking them out to create a sudden pressure change. They did the same with the ears, then the mouth. I suppose it would be scary for those people who read the disinformation on many websites about microchip implants or watched the movie Mission Impossible 2. That is not how the CIA tortures people. Only the belief of thinking they put in an exploding microchip works to control people into committing acts of murder through fear. I found cases where women killed their babies and such after talking to voices that told them to do it. Then they end up being imprisoned in an insane asylum or other. I know these the United States EEG heterodyning Satanist methods well. They truly are sociopaths and need to practice on the United States citizens before doing it to an important target like an Iraqi or such. The CIA used to call their torturers rough boys. Bioelectromagnetic antenna implants are no longer needed to pinpoint the directed energy at the target. And brain chip implants are ancient military technology and no longer used on most targets. People often believe when the synthetic telepathy program begins that it is coming from their fillings or a tooth implant due to the literature and misinformation like from the movie, Real Genius. Everyone has heard about braces picking up radio stations. Microwave hearing effect is even different than neural interfacing speech or ultrasonic heterodyning. Uses of EEG heterodyning by the DoD. Other than random experimentation, many individuals are targeted to be silenced or discredited. I know of a colonel who witnessed the army unloading bags of cocaine from a transport. He became a victim shortly after expressing concern. An FBI special agent for international terrorism became a victim after he testified that the FBI was perjuring itself at a trial. The former head of the LA FBI has become a target. Journalists who have written about these topics have been punished with the system. Anyone who has worked for the DoD and then later leaves may be subject to this covert type of assassination years later to silence potential security leaks. I have interviewed several families where they had a relative who went crazy and got locked up in a sanitarium after that member started talking about that they were an assassin for the United States. The doctors always said, "Don't listen to what they say. They are delusional." This diabolical, systematic method of silencing potential leaks has been employed by the DoD for many decades and usually carried out by the CIA, known as the slime balls of the sub-intelligence community. I can't believe we have had so many presidents with the background of federally sponsored crime. Everybody who knows what the government is doing is under a great deal of scrutiny and threat of reprisals. So I especially commend the MIT professors and students involved in dispelling the myth that aluminum beanies block EEG heterodyning. they used a $250,000 network analyzer to view the resonance signatures emitted by the human body to determine that the hats actually act like antennas for those frequencies rather than a shield. Like the terrorists have done in the past, the CIA is notorious for doing. That is making money off of stock market prediction of major events and creating front companies to fund their more odious undertakings so as not to be as easily dissuaded by threats of budgetary cuts by Congress. Psychotroic hostages. The United States secret heterodyned, psychotroic, mind control prisons hold many people hostage in this country and around the world, some politically motivated while others appear to be random experimentation. Shocking as this may be, you must remember we are a hypocrisy, not a democracy. We use the most autodemocratic methods to intimidate, overthrow, and control other countries. The army was recently ousted for putting false articles and news reports in Iraqi information streams, for example. From my research, there is more information warfare directed at the citizens of the United States than abroad. After being awoken from the American dream into the ugly reality of brutality, lies, and mind control so overtly and routinely practiced, I can't watch the news on television without feeling nauseous. I take tens of calls a day and answer countless emails from victims being brutalized by these weapons daily, then I see a report of a cat stuck in the tree which a fireman had to rescue. The absurdity of what is considered important enough to report on the mass media terrifies those who know what's really going on. When did we lose control of the free press? How are politicians kept in the dark of this military coup? Why can't they pass simple updated laws to at least openly protect citizens from the psychotroic massacre? Another method of covering up top secret technology and its abuses, I found while digging through the archives of DARPA, CIA, and DoD-funded research, technologies that I worked on decades ago are still being funded today to look as though no progress has been made. Why hasn't the weapon been more widely used for war? It doesn't have the success rate needed to be reliably used for war in place of ground troops. It probably is being used as a supplement. According to European Parliament documents, it was used in Desert Storm to fatigue and demoralize troops. Also, if it were successfully used in war once, countries would invest more into a tip psychotroic defenses. So it is considered more valuable as a political dissident silencing, spying, espionage, and silent assassination tool. I don't believe brain waves can be read by satellites. How can you prove this? It can be done by over-the-horizon radar bouncing their signals off the ionosphere as well as by satellites. HAARP and the Puerto Rico ionospheric heaters are examples of these ground-based high-powered phased arrays. Satellites could make it a truly global system. A couple simple mathematical calculations can demonstrate it. First, take the resolution of the Hubble Space Telescope or large radio Earth-based telescopes and calculate the sensitivity. Secondly, you must consider active scanning techniques which increase the signal-to-noise ratio tremendously, such as electron spin resonance and scatter stealth radar techniques. Thirdly, compare the sensitivity of SQIDs, superconducting quantum interference devices, with an electrically resonating biotelemetric antenna with modulated body electricity in it viewed from a low Earth orbit of 1,000 miles. It is within many orders of magnitude capable of detecting the signal, especially if the exact location were known. However, that is not what they are doing. They are using high-powered, nearly perfectly destructive interfering M waves which reflect or scatter with intense power levels back to their sources without burning the area of interest and without losing much of the signal-to-noise ratio from the absorption, scatter, transmittance, and reflectance energies. Lastly, look at the military research and patent files to find many published articles about reading heart and respiratory signals at a large distance. NASA even offered to build brain printing technology for airport security. The void of research at reading brain waves without EEG probes should tell you something. Do an internet search on mind control. Explain the amount of disinformation, misinformation, and general discussion around this topic if it can't be done. Explain why a very successful microwave antenna military subcontractor has a patent from the 1970s that claim brain reading and control. Explain why documents released through the Freedom of Information Act by the CIA openly discusses research on a project called RIC, Remote Hypnotic Intercerebral Control, using the same techniques. Clearly, this is such an important scientific discovery for weapons, spying, and espionage that much neurological data and research has been buried under the guise of national security bullshit. Even if you could read brain signals, how can you influence the nervous system? The reverse process is true. Have you ever tried a tens or muscle stimulator that contracts your muscles by pulsating a 70V small amperage current through the area? The brain works on ionic electric currents too. Have you noticed that your cell phone sometimes causes audio experiment nearby to chirp right before you get a phone call? Microwave-directed energy weapons are being developed to knock out and fry any electrical component not properly shielded. EMP, electromagnetic pulse, weapons can stall car engines, stop or cause bombs to detonate, and cause brain currents to misfire. Absorption of M energy at specific resonance frequencies have been shown to cause neurotransmitter release in neurons when absorbed by the brain. Even low-intensity magnetic fields have been shown to create currents in the brain or alter brain activity. The bioelectric and electromagnetic biochemistry mechanisms are too numerous to list. Okay, so the physics is sound. One could read and influence brain waves perhaps by terrestrial antennas or satellites, but how can you heterodyne different brain waves? Everybody is different. Everybody is a little different, a normal distribution around some average model. Deciphering a person's brain waves and mapping them to subjective experience is what has already been done. Because this idea is so disconcerting to many people, it might be considered dangerous knowledge for a population which would start questioning their religious, philosophical, and moral beliefs. Nobody wants their soul to be reduced to an electrical signal. The army published some documents showing how they mapped out the sensory pathways as an example. A project which I believe is to mislead the public on the current state of technology is called the Human Cogome Project, which has similar goals to the Human Geome Project. Very briefly, there is software that auto-correlates the brain patterns of individuals in a system called TMI, Thought and Memory Interface. That's incredible. But why would a government torture their own citizens? The United States has a long ugly history of doing this. There are massive cover-ups and barely a mention in the news when the programs are discovered. The same weapons testing programs continue, often under new funding and a different name. There is almost no oversight for top secret programs. Virtual human dissections of random citizens has been occurring since the inception of the CIA and definitely just after World War II and Project Paperclip, where many Nazi scientists were excused for their war crimes and sheltered by the duty. How can we fix our broken government and stop those dishonorable men and women who are abusing the public trusts and funds? The most difficult hurdle for us is the seemingly apathetic, self-centered, nearsighted mentality of the general public. Getting people to care what is happening to their future and country is difficult when you don't have control of the main media outlets. Grassroots effort at educating the public until a critical mass of awareness is reached will be the only way to pressure lasting changes and protections. There have been many violent acts misdirected to the wrong branches of government by these mind-control torture victims, but they are written off in the news as random acts of madmen and extremists. Publicly shaming the perpetrators and culprits will set a precedence. Trying to recruit the help of other countries to pressure the United States to free its psychotroic hostages would help. Get academic intuitions and other governments to discuss their psychotroic research openly. The United States is the only major country not to sign international treaties to ban the use of these weapons, clearly because they enjoy torturing their own population too much. Even Russia tried to get these weapons banned at a UN conference and the United States refused. I can't believe such important scientific discoveries are hoarded by the killing machine. Didn't they weigh the benefits of all the lives this technology would save against the potential use for killing many more? Apparently, defense is not about saving lives, it's about killing other people more efficiently. They don't get metals or more power by saving American lives through technological discoveries, they get more power by instigating wars and killing effectively. They are selfish, suboptimal decision makers. Clearly there is a problem with intellectual meritocracy in the culturally evolvagey military upper ranks since they were raised with good old-fashioned fascism. What makes it so difficult to get the attention of the world on such an immediately important issue? Good question. The media refuses to cover it, either because they have been instructed to or they have succumbed to the decades of brainwashing which states that if anyone claims that they have symptoms of psychotroic weapons that they are crazy. It is too controversial a topic and they are afraid of military reprisals may be the other reason. The psychological programming of the populace is extensive. At last count, I found over 100 movies and TV shows that make fictional references to mind reading and influencing technology. It has become common sense fiction in most people's minds. Also, we tend to trust and believe Washington DC spokespeople, but no, they lie all the time. Portagos has come out saying that they don't torture people. I know this to be a lie, yet he sounds so sincere when he is quoted in the papers or on TV. Like quantum theory and relativity, the physics is just not intuitive, so it is easy to believe that time is constant, the earth is flat, and mind-reading radar is impossible. Stupid alien tricks. I acquired two new abilities with the government neural link experiments conducted on me for the entire spooky year, October 31, 2004, October 31, 2005. I became a human compass. By minimizing the pain I felt through aligning my arms stretched out with the Earth's magnetic lines of force, I would always point in a north forward slash south direction. I carried a compass with me everywhere, and liked to demonstrate my stupid alien trick to anyone with whom I felt like striking up a conversation. The other capability I acquired was the ability to tell time down to the minute without a watch. It was a game that I played with the operators to whom I was e.g. heterodyned. They would accurately tell me the time whenever I asked. This really impressed a couple people. They had no idea how I could point to north forward slash south after being spun around with my eyes closed or tell the precise time whenever they wanted. A couple people bought me a beer for the bar tricks. I never told them how it was done for obvious reasons. Since the physical torture stopped, I haven't been able to perform either trick again. But the human compass capability does point out a potential weakness in the weapons system. If they are using linearly polarized electromagnetic waves for the scalar radar energy or ESR, MRI magnetic fields, the target object may disappear or the neural link signal weaken when aligned with the Earth's magnetic or the scalar radar electromagnetic fields. Silencing security leaks, whistleblowers, political activists, and hindering scientific discovery. Psychotroics is a very covert way to take out perceived problems for particular interests in the government. Rather than openly assassinate people or harbor political prisoners as in other communist countries, the United States prefers this slyer method. Just as with torture without physical evidence, termed soft torture, it quietly and effectively does the trick. Coal miners used as slaves were hobbled by breaking of their ankles to keep them from running away and demonstrated in the movie, Misery. Brain hobbling through psychotroics is done today in an analogous fashion. By using psychotroic generators to inject minute random currents into the targeted brain, a threat will exhibit schizophrenic thinking and can be thrown into a mental hospital where further silencing can occur without their consent. Neural scientists are closely watched and any who get too close to rediscovering the government's mind control technology can be mentally hobbled to prevent further discovery. Without visible political prisons and torture scars, the public will remain discredulous that it is being done. It is all about plausible denial. We surely are more civilized than the medieval kings with their large torture chambers. Everything is just invisible now, but the same brutal, unevolved people run them. Plead to the reader. Once again, I need to reiterate my credibility since the programming of the masses has taken place over so many years with such great influence. I have everything to lose by divulging these secrets of the government. I was earning $140,000 average pay in Silicon Valley before I morally felt obligated to disrupt their lies through my public voice by taking 2 years off and writing this book. Truth is not so terrible once you accept it. Only with truth can we triangulate on a better future and hold those erroneous thinkers accountable for their beyond top secret decisions that we, their employers, need to responsibly make in order to further efficiency, progress, and change in the duty and in politics that have allowed for the random selection of humans for their trite experiments for over 30 plus years. They will take our money on a boondoggle to employ endless projects that they declare for national security, killing millions by their withholding of technology and secrets. Power is addictive when you have no true value. I will use harsh words here to once more plead to the American public to investigate this issue independent of the corrupt chain of command. There is nothing that I despise more than corruption. The CIA's motto is "Ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free." Crock of shit. They are tasked with suppressing truth. And Porter Goss, who is an alumni from my private school, was supposed to bring justice, freedom, and truth to the American people. But instead he has fallen prey to the business as usual foul element of criminals that make up the house of ill deceit. The CIA needs to be disbanded of its criminal elements. What have they done for us? They knew about 9/11 but decided not to prevent it. They have tortured and killed more Americans in their declassified top secret programs than any terrorist group in history. But we chose to ignore it. We prefer delusion over truth. It is simply more pleasing for most people to believe their government is not corrupt and we are morally justified in policing, not occupying, 135 nations on Earth where we have troops stationed. There are only 55 nations that we haven't taken over. This is the wake-up call. If you chose to ignore it, history will not be your savior. You were told and you chose not to voice or act in the best interest of your fellow humans. You will be on the wrong side of history. George Bush is a puppet leader or a criminal. Those are the only two choices. Type miserable failure into Google to get his biography. The disinformers found they cannot control the internet for leaks, but they can flood it with disinformation. So you need to dig deep and remember the formula that I described for their disinformation tactics. Think what the United States has done through global tyranny with satellite and over-the-horizon radar-based neurological weapons. There is no sanctuary on Earth that one can just say, "I give up, I will leave and be done with you." You will be tortured till the end of the Earth by whichever corrupt general, colonel, or CIA director decides your fate. Are you scared yet? You are just beginning to understand the situation the people of Earth are faced with. Cope with the ugliness of the truth for which we work, and maybe we can fix it if it isn't too late. Or maybe you will decide that you don't care about truth, reality, as long as you can be led to believe that your small universe and fragile house of cards belief system is enough to keep you happy. You should stop reading this book now in that case. I am a habitual truth teller, insensitive and direct. My duty torturers said to me at the beginning of my year-long journey into hell, "You know too much. We must kill you. You get the benefit of my life learnings of knowing too much without the threat of death." Well worth your $20 bucks or so to buy this book, wouldn't you say? The madness of this world has lulled the masses into a slumber. Wake up. An eye is upon you. An eye ready to blink. So, face forward with arms wide open and minds reeling. Your future has arrived. Unknown author. Welcome to MKUltra. Would you like to be fried with that? The making of assassins MKUltra style. During the severe torture and psychic directed energy assignation attempts, the victim is encouraged to commit acts of violence against anybody the attackers can make the victim believe is doing it to them, usually neighbors, ex-lovers, or ex-bosses. The directed energy weapons test victim will easily be discredited as a violent loony in the news. The police and FBI will not ask any further questions about the incident either because of trained ignorance or orders. If the victim survives this phase, which can last several months or years, a hypnotic pulsing is used to subdue the victim so that they don't seek revenge on military installations or the CIA for trying to kill them and for torturing them. An apathy signal and permanent hypnotism is used to keep the victim subdued until their death in a soulless, mind-controlled emptiness trapped in a secret prison camp in their own brain. Have I congratulated you yet for living in the land of freedom? How to defuse Mashuria candidates, walking time bombs, and CIA-programmed assassins. There are only a handful of scripts and methods the CIA Shadow Subintelligence Agency use when practicing their trade and developing their methods. All the scripts rely on creating incredible anger through endless torture, frustration because no one will believe them or help them, and then redirecting the anger to a person, usually a neighbor, local authorities, FBI, president, political party, an ex-boss, or ex-lover, or some variation. Redirecting the anger and frustration while pushing them to the brink of violence is the strategy in creating a mind-controlled assassin or Mashuria candidate. There are only a couple variations using obsession and love as the delusional driving method to motivate an assassin. Two well-known love-driven assassins were John Lennon's and President Reagan's shooters. I have only met one colonel from the Air Force that had the delusional love affair mind control experiment done on him. It appears that there was no follow-up yet to direct him to kill a specific target except maybe the famous singer who he was mind-controlled into believing suddenly left him. He recognizes it now as a delusion so powerful that he divorced his real wife. He was flying top secret planes at the time it began. So I am sharing some very basic methods with other nations and this one for whomever will listen how to defuse these MKUltra e.g. heterodyned programmed assassins. Neural programming, psychic driving, depatering, torture, Skinner behaviorism, neuro-linguistic programming, hypnosis and many other techniques are used on these many government projects as they are called, or CIA/do deep psychotronic slaves. In order for there not to be an easy association between the violent outbreak and mind control experimentation, almost all projects must be classified as mentally ill first before triggering them. The news or ignorant local authorities will report a mentally ill person went wacko, for no reason. That way the subject will be arrested and disposed of once the assassination has been completed by local authorities. Taken from CIA documents, see appendix. That document amongst hundreds of thousands of others in the last year have been reclassified by the CIA as secret and taken out of the Library of Congress. I am republishing some of these documents in the appendix. It is truly sickening how this has all been covered up and will never make it into public school history books to warn the next generation to be more vigilant, maintain the standards of the Constitution by selflessly putting time into political activism and educating themselves on the issues. Just watching the hypotube will do nothing but program you with paid advertisements and government-sanctioned information. The tortured victims are often stalked, neurons amplified with electromagnetics, and often they have been drugged with long-term hallucinogens which make them paranoid or from their perspective, sensibly sensitive. 1. These artichoke assassins or domestic terrorists in the making simply need non-government tortured people to acknowledge that it may be happening to them which will diminish their frustration level. 2. They want to be believed, and to know that you will keep a watch out for unusual activity. 3. You will do a little research to see if there is precedence for what they are going through. If you suspect your neighbor to be one of these victims, I thoroughly recommend that you take these steps to defuse the situation. The perpetrators or operators of these mind-control assassination experiments almost always use the neighbors to gaslight the increasing paranoia. Some neighbors may be undercover spooks and decoys while most are innocent. The torture which feels like you are being microwaved is timed with neighbors coming home from work and often doing home repairs with construction-like equipment. Voices are thrown from the neighbors' apartments using the ventriloquism methods I described elsewhere in this book. You won't believe how many victims are 100% convinced their neighbors or cars parked outside their homes contain this very sophisticated weapon and is being used locally. They file lawsuits against their neighbors or worse. It is all about the timing of the torture and voices. Naturally, over time the victim will see a complete correlation of neighbor movements and noise correlated with their pain and suffering. With each reported case to the local authorities, more desensitized they become to it and more enforced is their policy to call these victims crazy. You can be a little hard on the local authorities for being uneducated in physics and history, but you can't blame them given their limited mental abilities for not being able to solve these kind of cases with such limited resources and access to federal level information. Plus, it is not their role to act as a sort of federal level internal affairs looking for high treason in the military and executive branches. They simply don't have the authority to investigate at this level. In fact, the reason that the three-prong government failed is because our founding fathers couldn't foresee the sophistication of the corruption and technology that would facilitate it. If they had foreseen it, they would have created a fourth branch of government whose sole existence was to act as internal affairs police to the other three with unlimited security clearance, their own military, and reports directly to the public. Shame game, try to make victim believe they brought it on themselves. Extreme brutality. One method to make victims' testimonies unbelievable is to make the torture and experimentation so extreme in intensity, carelessness, and duration as to make anyone who speaks of it sound delusional. There is no way the American government would allow torture and practice assassinations on random citizens. They would be caught at some point and exposed, is the general thought process of the average American who doesn't know CIA/DOD's history. The psychology of the ultra mind control programs. Isolation and sensory deprivation. Breaking down the self. Reprogramming. Dream manipulation. Our revels now are ended. These our actors, as I foretold you, were all spirits, spooks, and are melted into air, into thin air. And, like the baseless fabric of this vision, the cloud-capped towers, the gorgeous palaces, the solemn temples, the great globe itself, yea, all which it inherit, shall dissolve. And, like this insubstantial pageant faded, leave not a rack behind. We are such stuff as dreams are made on, and our little life is rounded with a sleep. Shakespeare, The Tempest, 4. 1. E.g. heterodyned inspired Hollywood movies. These weapons tests by treasonous power addicts in the conspiracy on people for the last 30 years have inspired many movies besides The Matrix. I have seen many movies where television white noise communicates voices or images. Poltergeist and White Noise are movies which describe the effects of Starkley's patent on voice transmission directly to the audio cortex. It is simply an amplification of the perceived sounds in the frequencies of the audio transmission. So white noise would be ideal for stimulating the neural frequency circuits that a voice transmission via induced neuro amplification would need. It would be perceived by the target as the voice coming from the sound source. A similar effect for visual imagery in white noise can be achieved with stimulating the visual cortex. More artichoke and mgultra with better cover-up. The CIA's programs and the TSS division who develops their drugs and technologies have not changed since the 1950s, except the remote hypnotic intercerebral control, subsumed under TMI, has improved dramatically. It also appears that they may be rerunning all the mgultra and artichoke remote assassination exercises. I found documents from the CIA in the book Secret Weapons that exactly described everything I was put through step by step. Nothing differed. But I still wonder how many drugs were used on me, or if they are rerunning their experiments on a massive scale to see if all the same effects from the drugs or tricks they use can be induced through pure electromagnetics. The item that most disturbs me in the released documents is that they say a test subject after committing an act of violence will be arrested by the involved agencies or government and thereby disposed of. I know of many cases the FBI did not solve correctly, and these practice assassinations landed these mind control victims in prison for life, or they got the death sentence. Discredited and disposed of permanently. Who is the greater threat, the CIA or the Russians? The CIA has killed and damaged our way of life far greater than any Russian attempt. Proud to be American, aren't you? These programmed assassinations get written off in the news as some crazy went on a killing spree. Most Americans, politicians, and FBI are ignorant that these unethical, immoral, and repetitive experiments in ever-growing numbers continue to this day nearly unchanged since the 1950s. An interesting note about the movie The Matrix is that Neo, played by Keanu Reeves, lived in room 101. Room 101 was where people were taken to be reprogrammed and tortured by their worst fears by the Big Brother Society of George Orwell's 1984. You suffer in your own private purgatory, a personalized hell. Sound familiar? Cataloging of mind variations. The cataloging of brainwave variations and testing of EEG cloning /heterodyning have been going on for a long time. With each brain variance analyzed and cataloged in the database, the mind control weapon becoming more effective on a larger part of the population and more difficult to stop. It appears to many that they are mopping up the outliers now. Assimilations into the brain profile database has picked up pace since 1996. Brain signal classification and experimentation. Imagine that you were abducted and now an experimental human animal, property of the CIA /duty. They place you on a table strapped down with your skull cut open and your brain exposed. They probe around with an electric probe to see what memories and functions they can stimulate. This goes on for months or years. You now have a sense what they are doing to thousands of people wirelessly. Is this allegation not important enough to sponsor an independent investigation, to commit a small amount of scientific expertise and monetary resources to nullify the population's fears that it could be true? Not a dime or person will be allocated to this. Are you frightened that America is not what it used to be, yet? Hypnosis as a weapon. There have been endless programs discovered by the Freedom of Information Act that show how the CIA is developing hypnosis as a weapon. RIC, Remote Hypnosis Intracerebral Control, is a continued program and part of the Weapons Effects Program. Hypnosis is mainly thought of as a way to cure bad habits or uncover repressed memories. It can be used very powerfully in reverse to repress memories, create false memories, and program assassins or self-destructive behavior. Classic methods of mind manipulation. Ego psychophotry is the manipulation method. The need to be valued is what we all have. The biggest obstacle to objective thinking is ego. It can be a driver to better ourselves, but the ego needs to be fed. It is a type of addiction. The larger part of one's drivers it becomes, more protection measures are created. It can be a source of great pleasure or great pain. It opens one up to being manipulated. Hope delusions. One will always prefer the pleasurable belief between two seemingly equally valid models of reality. Hope gives us meaning and direction. Most people hold many irrational beliefs because they feel good. It begins in childhood with beliefs in Santa Claus and the Tooth Fairy, and continues in more complex forms into adulthood. Fear-driven versus pleasure-driven people. There is an overall classification that people can be divided into those whose behaviors tend to revolve around worry, fear, and focus on avoidance of the fearful events. Then there are those that are bold, fearless, and whose behaviors tend to be seeking pleasures and adventures, often appearing reckless in nature to the former types. Value creating the perception of value. Scarcity, desirability by others. We tend to value objects or even significant others at an extreme, by how desirable they are to others. Diamonds are a good example of this effect. A somewhat rare carbon formation that has very few practical applications, but because others value it, we do too. If suddenly everyone decided it was just a rock, the value of diamonds would fall to near zero instantly. Maslow's hierarchy of needs is another psychological model of motivators, which includes some of the more primitive base drivers. Advertising and sales use all the above psychological control mechanisms to manipulate people's desires. This is an accepted form of mind control because one should be able to resist undue persuasion at one's own detriment through rational thinking. The same techniques are utilized for political campaigning. Carefully constructed images of ideal leaders are plotted. Acting has proven to be the most important skill in our leaders, ironically, since we have very little true knowledge of their competency or core values. The mind probe. Using a modified brain printing technique, EEG cloning can capture the moment of a guilty response feeling and continuously replay those brain signals to try and stimulate the memories surrounding the associated response. This is often more useful than the original brain printing method of simply identifying the guilty emotional response in order to infer truth. That system can be given false positives by pressing on the sternum by either of the EEG heterodyned participants because the feature set for classification must include a similar sensory signal. So the mind probe can be used in reverse to defeat polygraph and brain printing truth technologies used in the justice system and in top secret clearance background checks in this country or abroad. Famous people targeted. Generally, they stay away from overt perceived auditory harassment of famous people but do not shy away from using the less obvious effects. It has been told to me from several sources that Michael Dukakis was targeted during his campaign for presidency. Also, the Russian chess master who played IBM's Big Blue computer complained about microwave confusion rays being directed at him. His society, Russia, is much more open about the discussion of neurological weapons. It is not a far stretch to see if political manipulation is being used by CIA/DoD who might have had an interest in assassinating JFK using a traditional mind-controlled patsy. The high office of president has been used to foment a plot to destroy Americans' freedom, and before I leave office I must inform the citizen of his plight. John F. Kennedy at Columbia University, 10 days before his assassination. The crimes by the CIA and DoD have been difficult to prove without any government help in equipment procurement and scientific expertise. There are thousands of people willing to testify. However, many of the victims have been successfully confused by the scripts and testing, and many others have been discredited by horrific tactics. There are still many like myself that have remained untouched by their attempts. Now you need a weapon and a motive for a case. The weapon is top secret and cleverly marketed as the Continental missile and over-the-horizon radar defense system. It is difficult to turn them off to prove where the signal is coming from and submit the giant miles-wide phased array antenna and participating satellites as evidence in court. The motive is complex since it operates at many levels. This complexity in both the science of the weapon and the diabolical motives are beyond the average person's intelligence and attention span to understand. In summary, the motive is human effects weapons testing and development for neurological weapons, but it goes much deeper than that. Even though torture and psychic assassinations are awful uses, the most disturbing to me and to democracy is that it is being used as a political manipulation tool in our own country and others. So even if you have the perpetrators, the weapon, and the motive, you would still need to find lawyers that wouldn't fear shadow government reprisals. On top of that, EEG heterodyning would be used to influence the judges and jury unless appropriate shielding and detection equipment were in place. It is difficult to see justice anytime soon. Psychology of torture. Torture is a tool used to achieve several goals during depatering, programming, and interrogations. Especially with the group in the DoD that is experimenting with machuria creation. How do you create attack dogs or vicious animals? You mistreat them. Bigotry, chauvinism, and homophobia is alive and well in the unevolved ranks of government. My cyber hive mind group of torturers were composed of a woman, an Indian, a black man, and a gay white man according to them. These are the groups they were trying to direct my anger at and associate the torture. I've heard similar stories from the many interviews I have conducted. Their scripts also try to point the finger at China, Arabs, and Russia as the culprits of psychotroic torture and tyranny. When it becomes obvious which country is behind it, based on the literature and technology capabilities, they try to point the finger at the FBI, thereby possibly provoking an attack on them like in the Oklahoma bomber case. Clearly missing is the finger pointing to the CIA who has continuously operated and funded these attacks on Americans and people worldwide in their quest for total mind control. This is fact if you care to educate yourself on the released federal documents. How will these experiments on creating bitter, angry dissidents be used? They can turn other countries' citizens against their own government. The technique all hangs on making the torture victim believe that a particular group did it to them. So stage a kidnapping, torture the victim with accents from the Patsy organization, set up a chance meeting with a CIA agent and they will be happy to help destroy those that the victim believes to be behind it. Creating spies and espionage agents out of people of their own kind is the goal of many of the CIA mind control technologies. Their experiments are reckless and careless as to the lives of the practice victims and society at large. They often try to make the victim believe that their neighbors, family, or ex-lover is behind their mental anguish, somehow connected to the conspiracy of field agents that execute these programs. One man I interviewed was convinced that President Clinton was behind his psychotroic torture because they used voice transformation technology to project Clinton's voice utilizing the electronic warfare unit's capability of overpowering radio transmissions and faked a broadcast specifically to him. People who are unaware of these techniques used in warfare will be left confused and feeling insane, which is the ultimate goal of covering up the human mind control experimentation program. The CIA sold crack in LA neighborhoods drug driving. Another reason I surmise that the crack sales to LA black neighborhoods were not just for raising money for the Contra rebels like the papers have reported is because three people I interviewed who had a drug history said that the behavior modification mind control program started out by a technique called drug driving. They described themselves as recreational drug users, and said that when the targeting began, they were given pain stimuli for certain drugs and suggestion to do other drugs with an induced spiral of depression and stress. This led them to cocaine or methamphetamine abuse, they claim. This is what would be needed to improve amplification of the voice recognition neural pathways identified by dopamine saturation, which facilitates the CIA synthetic telepathy to be used at low power intensities. It could also have the dual purpose of discrediting the human experiment. More stupid alien tricks. Here's a funny experiment conducted on me. My EG brain partner bit into a lemon. The sour reflex cloned to me and they were able to capture the reflex to replay continuously. They always told me in advance what they were testing. I was left lecturing to my class with a lisp for 15 minutes. My voice changed and I sounded ridiculous. My students commented on it. If any of my former students are reading this book, they will remember that day. I chewed some gum to disrupt the signal. How embarrassing. You can image how useful this trick would be to use on a political candidate. Sacrifices and cannibals. While we are in this barbaric land of deception, I thought that I would point out an interesting but soon to be extinct species. Stephen Gould taught me about catastrophic evolution and species that have produced cannibalistic mutations. If the cannibal gene is not removed from the genetic pool, the species becomes a leaf on the evolutionary tree. In human history, we have evolved this gene several times but have been able to contain it. Phylogenetically, survival occurs because the dominant social structure recognizes the detrimental behavior and alters its mating probabilities or kills off the unsociable elements. Now, unlike other times in the history of life, a cannibalistic tribe has again emerged, partially genetically influenced and partially culturally or memenically altered. The shadow government and their DoD/CIA weapons developers have evolved this detrimental mutation. They have been sacrificing and cannibalizing thousands of peaceful people in our civilization at random for many decades now. My research shows that it is growing in numbers as their budgets increase. The mentality is proliferating out of control. The militant minds have found a new way to replicate their sociopathic thinking and behavior. It must be stopped. But most unique to this cannibal strain, is that they have found a way to mimic the rest of society by thoroughly studying relationships, speech, and personality profiles and hiding behind their application of the psychology of persuasion. This makes it extremely difficult for the trusting population to see what they are without enormous amounts of research and time to validate their statements and evaluate their actions independent of mass media programming. Stupid alien tricks. Enough of my shamings for a moment. Let's relax to another stupid evil alien trick. So when my EG heterodyne hoaxers tried to panic me by trying to convince me that they could give me a heart attack, they would press on the right side of their chest, which I would feel as internal pain, and say, "We are burning your heart. We are giving you a heart attack with directed focused energy to your heart." My reply to them, "The heart is on the left side of the chest, Gultra Moran." But that's good enough for government work. It happened several times. These evil aliens aren't the brightest bulbs in the bunch. That is probably why they crash landed on Area 51. And this is why they practice on citizens. It fooled Saddam Hussein. Those CIA agents must have been pros and pressed on the left side. Good for them. This summons the image from the movie The Matrix, where Neo restarts Trinity's heart in the Matrix after a virtual bullet shot by the agent stops it. Truth and guilt. Truth is the summation of all self-consistent perspectives. It is what our model of reality should asymptotically approach but can never reach. The practice that psychic soldiers and MKUltra survivors undergo is to defeat guilt-determining devices. I spent a week while under MKUltra mind control experiments learning how to defeat brain printing and traditional polygraph techniques, and the attackers practiced inducing false positives on these devices while I spoke. These tools are clearly useless with EEG heterodyning technologies and remote hypnosis. Spooks, goons, zombies, and the pentagram. The Halloween theme and the satanic cult cover story never ended with my mind manipulation data collectors. They even pointed out that the United States flag is satanic and has an unlucky 13 prison stripes representing imprisonment of the 50 pentagrams on it. I suppose they were trying to break down my patriotism. However, the damage is done, and now I would now like to see the flag updated to something more cheerful. Here is the flag forced into my mind's eye. Genetic and cultural memory. Our DNA has a memory. If you model DNA as a biochemical computer, you can understand how memory is created in the evolutionary machine. Let's ask, why do birds or sheep flock? At some point there must have been a survival advantage, since the sole purpose of the genetic program is survival. Certainly flocking together makes it easier for a wolf to find a bountiful food source. It seems that due to limited food supply that flocking might even be a disadvantage. However, sexual reproduction is far more important for continuance than the disadvantages of grouping. This socializing gene, which gives rise to the subjective experience of needing companionship, is also the memory of the genetic strain to which this behavior was advantageous. Our primitive drives are composed of genetic memories and programs. The Nazi study of evolution through this model was called eugenics, or directed evolution, implemented through genocide. Culturally, a similar phenomena can be observed. Culture, group behavior that is not genetically directed, evolves through memes and has memory that is stored within people's mind and passed on through storytelling or chimpanzee-like mimicry of learned cultural norms. The CIA is also conducting genocide of memes and belief systems, or euphoized as directed cultural evolution. Suffering and mind control. There have been many books which study the MKUltra torture techniques and mind control, so I won't detail it here. But it is interesting to note that these techniques of mind control have existed long before the CIA. Suffering has been linked primitively to a creation of loyalty and comradeship. From medical doctors that suffering, the rite of passage of intense schooling, to boot camp and unnecessary military hardships, to religions that suffer on a day of denial or more severe tortures, like with Christianity in the days of old with beating the demons out, or self-mutilation to suffer like Jesus did in vain. All these kinds of events cause a sense of belonging because of the pain, and a sense of comradeship between all those that went through the same experience. Even a cultish, fun event like Burning Man that takes place in the harsh conditions of a desert each year, creates a sense of suffering together for a greater cause. This mentality may give rise to the Stockholm syndrome of hostages becoming sympathetic for their captor's cause. I was probably not mind controlled into CIA slavery from the torture because I despise anything that causes me pain. That's probably why I'm not married to. Moral cataclysms. One foreseeable worry that the CIA /DOD has is repeating what happened to Rome with its moral cataclysm and Christianity. However, the new religion is science. How will knowledge of the scientification of the human soul be accepted by the general religious masses? One such experiment I believe to see if science and religion can mix to form a new set of moral teachings and beliefs is Scientology. I believe that this is very much a CIA-funded experiment. For my next book, I plan to infiltrate this perceived cult to find out more about its teachings and how they are so intertwined in the literature of CIA mind control experimentation. The CIA expert with whom I consult told me that L. Ron Hubbard got his PhD thesis on creating cults. Justice denied. unsolved mysteries. The real problem with a small group of people who control these technologies unwatched by public eyes is its potential for great abuse. For example, we can never fully solve any accident or crime and know whether it was an EEG heterodyned crime or a regular one. Princess Diana's driver could have been EEG heterodyned and made to crash into the barrier. John Hickley could have been made to believe that only by shooting President Reagan could he get Jodie Foster to love him. I met a colonel in the Air Force who test flew the new exotic airplanes and who was meticized after discovery of all sorts of corruption with her Liberto defense contracts. False memories were implanted in him and he was made to believe he was married and had a kid with some music star for 2 years. Clearly the capability exists to create mashurias like John Hickley. JFK Jr. could have been made to misinterpret the horizon or his aircraft instruments to malfunction. Flight 800's fuel tank could have been sparked by directed energy weapons. All these events could have been assassinations using EEG heterodyning and directed energy weapons, but we will never know. How can you have justice when one cannot be certain as to whose mind was behind the crime, or even if the jury or judge is being influenced? Clearly the current controls have failed and a major reorganization of the government is justified to regain constitutional controls over these weapon systems in order to restore justice, redistribute the power structure evenly again, and hold accountable high traitors and special interest corruption from sidestepping the laws and constitution.